So today we are going to learn about volcanoes. Okay, so what are volcanoes basically? You can see in this video here a lava coming out of the volcano. So basically volcanoes are openings in the earth's crust. Yes, we have layers, and in the earth's crust there are the openings through which molten rock, ash and gases can erupt. This occurs when pressure builds up beneath the Earth's surface, leading to the release of these materials. Volcanoes can be found on land or under water and are often associated with tectonic plate boundaries. The erupted material can form mountains, lava plateaus, or volcanic islands. Eruptions vary in intensity from gentle flows to explosive eruptions with ash clouds and pyroclastic flows. Okay, volcanoes, as the definition mentioned here, are geological features that result from Earth's dynamic processes. They typically form at plate boundaries where tectonic plates either collide, move apart, or slide past each other. There are various types of volcanoes that we are going to study in the coming slides. So what you're seeing here is Ring of Fire, and Ring of Fire is horseshoe shaped. Okay, it's a zone around the edges of the Pacific Ocean basin. This region is known for its high volcanic and seismic activity due to the presence of several tectonic plate boundaries. The Ring of Fire is home to about 75% of the world's active and dormant volcanoes, as well as frequent earthquakes. The tectonic plates along the Ring of Fire are dynamic, interacting through subduction zones where one plate is forced beneath another. This subduction process often leads to the formation of deep sea trenches, volcanic arcs, and volcanic chains. Notable features along the Ring of Fire include the Andes in South America, the Cascade Range in North America, the Japan Archipelago, and the Philippines. The intense geological activity in the Ring of Fire makes it a geologically dynamic and potentially hazardous area. Earthquakes and volcanic eruptions are common, and some of the world's most powerful and destructive seismic events have occurred in this region. So let's understand what are the parts of a volcano. Okay, a volcano consists of various parts, as you can see here in the diagram, and each playing a role in the process of volcanic activity. So we'll start with the crater. What is a crater here? It's a bowl-shaped depression at the summit of a volcano formed by previous eruptions. It is often the location of the central vent. Then what's a sill? A sill is a type of intrusive igneous rock formation that occurs when magma is injected into the cracks or layers of pre-existing rocks and solidifies underground. Sills are horizontal or near horizontal bodies of rock, if you can see here in the depiction. What is magma chamber? An underground reservoir that holds molten rock. Pressure builds up in this chamber, leading to volcanic activity. What's a vent? As I have explained in the earlier, the opening through which volcanic material, including lava, ash, and gases, is expelled to the Earth's surface. Okay, this is the vent. Okay, on the sides or even at the base of a volcano. What's a lava flow? The flow which is coming out of the vent. So molten rock that reaches the Earth's surface. It can flow downhill, covering the surrounding terrain and solidifying as it cools. Here at the above, you can see that there is an ash cloud. Okay, after the eruption, there is a cloud. So this cloud is fine particles of volcanic ash and dust that can be ejected high into the atmosphere during an eruption, affecting weather and air travel. What's the cone here? The cone of a volcano is the three-dimensional structure you can see here in this diagram. that forms as a result of accumulated volcanic material such as lava, ash, and debris around the vent. It gives the volcano its characteristic shape, and different types of cones include stratovolcanoes, shield volcanoes, and cinder cone volcanoes that we are going to learn in the upcoming slides. Okay. What is conduit? A conduit is, in the context of a volcano, refers to the pipe-like channel that allows magma to move from the magma chamber beneath the Earth's surface to the surface during an eruption. It acts as a pathway for the molten rock. Here it is, if you can see in this diagram. I hope the parts of the volcano are clear to you now. So here it's the description of the parts of the volcano. You can try to pause and also refer them as well. Okay. Now we will understand what are the types or how many types of volcanoes are there. So the first type of volcano that we will be studying is a shield volcano. It is a type of volcano characterized by its broad, gently sloping profile resembling a warrior's shield. These volcanoes are primarily built by the flow of low viscosity basaltic lava, which travels long distances from the vent. Here are some key characteristics of shield volcanoes mentioned here, such as eruption style. So, volcanic eruptions are non-explosive and effusive and involve the outflow of lava, right? So, they have the flow of lava is relatively fluid lava, typically basalt, which allows the lava to flow easily and cover large areas. This results in the gradual broad slopes associated with the shield volcanoes. So it has gentle slopes. Unlike most steep-sided volcanoes, shield volcanoes have gentle, gradually sloping slides. The accumulation of numerous thin lava flows contributes to the shield-like shape. Okay, and they have large size. Shield volcanoes are often larger in terms of surface area compared to other types of volcanoes. They can cover extensive areas and reach great heights, although their slopes are not as steep. Shield volcanoes tend to have relatively frequent but non-explosive eruptions, as I just mentioned. Relatively, and the lava flows from these eruptions typically not as viscous, allowing for a steady release of pressure. For example, you can relate to prominent volcanoes here in Etna in Italy, okay, Mauna Loa in Hawaii. So these are some of the examples. So another type of volcano is cinder cone volcano. A cinder cone volcano is a type of a volcano that is typically small in size and has a steep conical shape. These volcanoes are built from the accumulation of volcanic debris such as ash, cinders, and volcanic rocks ejected during explosive eruptions. The style of eruption of cinder cone volcanoes are associated with explosive eruption, where gas-rich magma is fragmented into small particles, creating a pyroclastic flow. This results in the deposition of ash and cinders around the vent. Now, unlike the shield volcanoes, cinder cone has single vent. Okay, so most cinder cone volcanoes have a single vent or central opening from which volcanic material is ejected. This differs from shield, right? As I just said, the slopes are steep due to the accumulation of loose volcanic material ejected during eruptions. Cinder cone volcanoes have steep slopes. The angle of these slopes is often close to the angle of repose, the steepest angle at which loose material can remain stable. This is the slope style of these volcanoes, and they're short-lived in terms of the comparison to other types of volcanoes in terms of their eruptions. The construction of the cone occurs rapidly during explosive events. Okay, and cinder cone volcanoes can be found in various tectonic settings, often occurring on the flanks of larger volcanoes or independently in volcanic fields. So another type is composite cone volcano. It is also known as stratovolcano, is a large and typically symmetrical volcano characterized by both explosive and effusive eruptions. Now you may ask, what is effusive? Effusive refers to a type of volcanic eruption characterized by the relatively gentle and steady flow of lava onto the Earth's surface. In effusive eruptions, what happens? The magma is typically low in viscosity, meaning it is less thick and flows more easily. This allows the lava to move smoothly, creating features such as lava flows and lava plateaus. Effusive eruptions are in contrast to explosive eruptions. As I just said, it has two types of eruptions. Okay, when in explosive, where magma is more viscous and contains a significant amount of gas. Explosive eruptions result in the ejection of volcanic ash, rocks, and gases into the atmosphere. The nature of an eruption, effusive or explosive, is influenced by factors such as magma composition, gas content, and the presence of tectonic plate boundaries. Overall, effusive eruptions tend to be less violent than explosive ones, and they often produce lava flows that can cover large area over time. So, for example, in shield volcanoes are a common result of effusive eruptions, but this one has both effusive and explosive. So here we are going to learn about the volcanic eruptions. So what are Icelandic eruptions? Icelandic eruptions occur in Iceland and are characterized by basaltic lava, effusive nature, and often involve fissure eruptions. Now you may ask, what are fissure eruptions, right? So fissure eruptions, instead of central or single, Icelandic eruptions frequently occur along fissures or crack in the Earth's crust. That is called as fissure. This can lead to the simultaneous eruption of multiple vents. Okay? These eruptions contribute to the formation of vast lava plateaus, Icelandic eruptions, and fields in Iceland landscape. While generally less explosive, they can pose hazards such as lava flows and ash fall. Notable in examples, as I mentioned, the Deccan Plateau in India, the Columbia Plateau in the western United States are both huge lava plateaus, with the Deccan Plateau covering around 1 lakh square miles and the Columbia Plateau being the largest lava plateau globally. Next is the Hawaiian eruption. Hawaiian eruption is a type of volcanic activity characterized by relatively gentle and effusive eruptions, typically involving the eruption of basaltic lava. The magma involved is basaltic, which has low viscosity, allowing for the smooth and fluid flow of lava. Hawaiian eruptions are generally non-explosive and effusive with lava flowing steadily from a central vent, right? And they are into shield volcanoes. These eruptions often lead to the formation of shield volcanoes. The lava flows from Hawaiian eruptions can cover large areas and move downslope, creating extensive lava fields. Hawaiian volcanoes are known for relatively frequent eruptions, with the activity being more continuous and less explosive compared to some other types of volcanoes. The other is the Strombolian eruption. It is a type of volcanic activity characterized by frequent moderate explosions. These eruptions involve the ejection of incandescent cinder ash and volcanic gases, creating bursts or fountains of lava. Strombolian eruptions are named after the volcano Stromboli in Italy, where this type of activity is frequently observed. A Vulcanian eruption is a more explosive type of volcanic activity compared to the Strombolian eruptions. It involves the ejection of large volumes of ash, volcanic debris, often forming a dense ash column. Vulcanian eruptions are named after the Roman god Vulcan and are associated with viscous magma that traps gases, leading to pressurized explosions. These eruptions typically result in the release of pyroclastic flows and can be hazardous to nearby areas. The stratovolcano eruption are also known as composite volcano eruption, and they are characterized by explosive eruptions due to the presence of viscous magma. These volcanoes are typically tall and steep side built up by the alternating layers of solidified lava, ash and volcanic rocks. Stratovolcanoes often produce pyroclastic flows, ash clouds and lava flows during eruptions. The explosive nature is attributed to the magma's high silica content, which makes it more viscous and prone to pressure buildup. Now, the Pelin eruption is named after volcano Mount Pelin, which experienced a devastating eruption in 1902. Pelin eruptions are characterized by the explosive eruption of highly viscous magma. These eruptions often result in the collapse of the volcanic dome, producing pyroclastic flows, fast-moving, extremely hot mixtures of volcanic gases, ash and debris. In 1902, eruption of Mount Pelin is a notable example of Pelin eruption, leading to the destruction of the town of Saint-Pierre, causing significant loss of life. Pliny eruption is a highly explosive volcanic event named after the Roman historian naturalist Pliny the Younger, who documented the eruption of Mount Vesuvius in 79 AD. Pliny eruptions are characterized by the eruption column reaching great heights in the atmosphere, often tens of kilometers. These eruptions produce vast amount of volcanic ash and other volcanic debris. During a Pliny eruption, large volumes of gas-rich magma are rapidly expelled, creating a towering eruption column. The collapse of this column can lead to pyroclastic flows, fast-moving, ground-hugging currents of hot gas and volcanic matter. Pliny eruptions are among the most powerful and destructive volcanic events, with the potential to impact global climate by injecting ash and aerosols into the upper atmosphere. Now let's learn about volcano eruption materials. So these are the materials volcanic eruptions expel. It's lava, molten rock that flows onto the Earth's surface during an eruption. It can be either fluid, a low viscosity, or sticky and thick, high viscosity. And of course we have volcanic ash. There are fine particles of rock and glass created during explosive volcanic eruptions. Ash clouds can pose significant hazards to both aviation and human health, which is formed over the event. Okay. Then we have, of course, the pyroclastic material. What is that? Rapidly moving mixtures of hot gas, ash, and volcanic rock fragments. These flows can be extremely destructive, moving downhill at high speeds. Pumice is a lightweight volcanic rock that forms when frothy lava solidifies quickly. It often floats on water. And then we, of course, have gases that include water vapor, carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, and other gases released from magma. These gases can contribute to air pollution and have effects on climate. So how one can be prepared for such hazardous events or volcanic eruptions? Very important to learn as well. So it's very important that one must be staying informed about it, that monitor official sources for volcanic activity updates and warnings. National geological agencies and meteorological services typically provide information. You should also have an emergency plan, have a family emergency plan in place. Identify evacuation routes, emergency shelters and communication strategies. Ensure that all family members are aware of the plan. Then you should also have an emergency kit. Prepare an emergency kit with essential supplies, including water, food, first aid supplies, flashlight, batteries, important documents and medications. And you should also have evacuation routes. You should be familiar with evacuation routes and follow official guidelines. Plan multiple routes in case some are blocked. You should also take protective measures. If advised to stay indoors, close windows and doors and use masks to protect against volcanic ash.
Have goggles and long-sleeved clothing for added protection. You should establish communication plan with family members and friends. Keep a battery-powered radio to receive updates if power is disrupted. You can consider if in case volcano insurance is there. In case you should be most important, you should be educated. Understand the types of volcanic eruptions in the region and the associated hazards. Educate yourself and the family and friends and safe and on the safety measures of it. Keep emergency contact. Keep a list of contact of people, including local authorities, services, and medical facilities. Thank you so much for watching. And if you have any questions and doubts, please reach out at vertixthesolution.com. I hope you enjoyed and liked this lecture on volcano types, eruptions, materials, and plan of action in case of it is related to your area. So do share your feedback, and if you require any other topic, I will upload the relevant topics for your upliftment as well. Thank you, and I hope the students who asked to share this presentation will find it beneficial, and you can also connect with me. And any presentation, any topic you want to learn, please share that with me, and I will upload on this channel. Have a great day and happy learning.